Early on, things couldn't have started better, I suppose. We were fortunate enough to get 2 inches in early April. That was enough for us to get into it and get sowing, and early rain, things were looking really good, I suppose, and then started to go a bit pear-shaped in the first week of August. We had a week of frost pretty much, where it got to -4 a couple of times, and for a long duration of time it was below zero, and that did a lot of damage here in the Mallee, or on our farm anyway. Once the crop was stressed then, I suppose, we never got any good follow-up rain after that, and then we just decided to end up cutting a fair bit for hay, I suppose, due to poor crop. I just went around the paddocks and cut a square metre of crop and took it home, microwaved it and dried it out to get me dry matter. Just did the maths then, and then compared that to driving around the crop, then looking at it for grain, comparing it for grain to what I thought it was going to go at the time. And that was how I assessed it, pretty much. It was only rubbery, but in the end, I don't think I was too far off. Yeah, hay's been good to us. Makes your decisions a lot easier, where in terms of costs, and perhaps by having our own gear, for me to go cut a paddock and cart a paddock and do all those things too, it doesn't seem to take a lot of time. It's not a lot of extra effort. So for us, that was a huge advantage. And it was probably more to the fact of when we cut it for hay, it was more about getting something back rather than nothing. If I'd have let it go through for grain, we wouldn't have got anything. And whereas this time, by cutting for hay, wasn't ideal, but I got something back to try and recover some of those costs. Currently, we've got a bit over 3,000 lambs on, and we try and buy them in September, I suppose, whatever the market seems to fit. And we just run them out on the paddocks, and I suppose by having the lambs and the hay, any wasted hay can go to the lambs, so you're not trying to not get any losses or things like that. So the hay seems to fit in good with the lambs as well. You can get them as soon as the hay comes off the paddock, you can get them on the paddocks earlier and things like that. Just seems to be working for us at the moment. And then we finish them off in the feedlots, the plan. That's just what we see fit at the moment, and hopefully we can continue to do it. Well, I don't cut hay specifically for our lambs. I predominantly aim for export with all our cereal. And then all the vetch hay and stuff that I cut goes to domestically, still here in Victoria. And like the wheat and barley that I did cut in 2014 that was severely frosted, that will still go domestically. The lambs don't take a huge amount of hay off us, because in the feedlot we generally give them just straw for a bit of roughage, which I do, and I might give them a few bales of barley or wheat or something in the paddock just to keep them happy. But the lambs aren't a huge part to do with the hay. If you have any waste hay, it's a good advantage to get rid of it, I suppose. Well, I won't change anything for 2015. Hopefully 2014 was one out of the box and we don't see it again, but I'll still prepare to sow in April, May again, and still use similar fertiliser, all those things. I don't want to change our program too much, just over 1 year that hasn't happened in a long time, I suppose you'd say.